So here's the setup. Imagine the total amount of money floating around in the economy goes up by 5%. At the same time, the economy itself, you know, all the actual stuff and services we produce, only grows by 2%. So you've got 5% more money chasing only 2% more stuff. So where did that extra 3% just go? Did it vanish?
You know, every good detective needs the right tool to crack a case. For an economic mystery like this one, our tool is a classic, time-tested formula. This is the key that's going to unlock how all these numbers fit together.
And here it is. Our master key is called the quantity theory of money. Now, that equation, N times V equals P times Y, might look a little intimidating, but the idea behind it is actually pretty straightforward. M is the total money supply. V is something called the velocity of money, basically how many times a single dollar gets spent in a year. That has to equal P, which is the overall price level, times Y, which is the real economic output. Think of it as a scale that has to stay balanced for the whole economy.
Okay, so our puzzle isn't about the total amount of money. It's about the growth in money, right? It's all in percentages. So we can't just use that base formula as is. We need a version that looks at the change in each of these variables over time.
And here's where a pretty cool math trick comes in. When you switch from looking at the absolute numbers to looking at their percentage changes, that multiplication formula magically turns into an addition formula. So, the change in money supply plus the change in velocity equals the change in prices plus the change in output. This is the formula that's going to help us crack this case.
All right, we've got our formula locked and loaded. Now it's time to play detective. We're going to go back to our original puzzle and pull out all the facts of the case, one by one.
So, clue number one. This one comes straight from the case file. We were told exactly how much the money supply grew. And there it is, a 5% increase. So our delta M, the change in the money supply, is plus 5%. Okay, one variable down.
Let's move on to the next piece of evidence. We also know something about the real economy. You know, how much more stuff was actually made during this time.
And that clue is a positive 2%. So our delta Y, the change in economic output, is 2%. We are getting really close now.
Now for the last and maybe the most crucial clue. What about that V term, the velocity of money? How fast was all this cash actually changing hands?
And here is a really important detail tucked away in the case file. The classic version of this theory works on one big assumption, that the velocity of money, the speed at which it gets spent, is constant. It just doesn't change. So for our puzzle, we're going to run with that assumption.
So think about it. If the velocity is constant, what's its rate of change? Well, it's zero, right? So our delta V is 0%. And just like that, we have all the clues we need to solve this thing.
Okay, the moment of truth. We have our formula. We have all our clues. It is time for the big reveal. Let's put everything together and finally figure out what that one missing piece of the puzzle is.
So let's just walk through it. Our equation is delta M plus delta V equals delta P plus delta Y. Let's plug in what we know. That's 5% plus 0% equals our mystery variable, delta P, plus 2%. That simplifies down to just 5% equals delta P plus 2%. Do a little quick algebra, and there it is. Delta P has to be 3%.
So, we did it. We solved for our mystery variable. We found the missing number. But what does a 3% change in P, the price level, actually mean? What's the verdict here?
This is it. 3%. This is where our quote-unquote extra money went. It didn't just disappear into thin air. And here is the solution to our mystery. That missing 3% wasn't missing at all. It was absorbed right into the economy, showing up as a 3% increase in the overall level of prices.
And what's the economic term for a general increase in prices over time? Well, that's inflation. The answer to our puzzle is that the economy experienced 3% inflation.
So let's just recap the whole case, start to finish. The amount of money in the system grew way faster than our ability to actually produce more stuff. And because we assumed that money was being spent at the same constant speed, all that extra cash had to go somewhere. It ended up getting soaked up by prices, pushing them higher. The final verdict? 3% inflation.
So, this simple theory gives us a really powerful way to look at things. But remember, the whole thing hinged on that one big assumption, that the velocity of money stays constant. So let me leave you with a final thought. What happens when that assumption isn't true?
In the real world, when people get scared and hoard cash, or get excited and spend it much faster, well, this neat and tidy equation gets a whole lot more complicated. And that is a puzzle for another day.